See, one of the easiest topic we have is Bolli's coefficient of skewness. In Bolli's coefficient of skewness or skewness based on quartiles, they can ask you in two ways. They can ask you Bolli's coefficient of skewness, or if they will not ask you Bolli's skewness, they will ask you skewness, find the skewness based on quartiles. So what we have to do is, you have to check whether the question is given in simple frequency distribution or not. That means class integral frequency is given or not. We don't find class integral frequency. Midpoints are given, so immediately we have to find class integral and frequency from this one. How to find class integral? I told you how to arrange the questions in video. In that video we find whenever midpoints are there, first see the difference, how much difference we have. 35, 45, 55, we find 10 units different in between the classes. So what you have to do is 10 divided by 5, 10 divided by 2. Difference divided by 2. We find difference 10 divided by 2, which is 5. So add 5 and subtract 5 to the value. Subtract and add 5. Means what? 35 is there. You can subtract 5 and add 5 to this 35. 35 minus 5 is 30. 35 plus 5 is 40. 30 to 40. Or in general, you can think 35 is mid value of 30 and 40. 45 is mid value of 40 and 50. 50 and 60. Similarly, 60 to 70, 70 to 80, 80 to 90, 90 to 100. Then 1, 3, 11, 21, 43, 32, and 9. So, class integral frequency. Check the question. In question, they have not given class integral frequency. They have given midpoints and frequency. What we have to do? We have to form the table. Form class integral and frequency. Then we have to move further. Bolli's skewness. You should know the formula of skewness of Bolli's. What is that? Bolli's skewness is Q3 plus Q1 minus 2 median divided by Q3 minus Q1. Now, by seeing the formula, we came to the conclusion that we need to find Q3, Q1, median, and we have to substitute all the three values in skewness formula. So for Q1, Q3 and median, we have to find cumulative frequency. That's all. 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 7, 15. This is 36 plus 43. 79, 81, 91, 102, 120. This is 120. N is 120, or sigma fi is 120, H is equals to 10. So, yes, N is 120 itself. Now we have Q3, Q1, median. You can find in any order. First Q3 is there, we will find Q3 here. Q3 is L plus, in bracket we have 3 N by 4 minus CF by small f into H. So what do we find now? 3 N by 4. You can find here also, no problem. First we find this value, 3 N by 4. 3 into 120 by 4. This is 90. Okay. Where we find 90, in 1 we have not, we can't include 90, 40, 36, 70. Here we can include 90. This is Q3 column, line L, F, opposite upper value CF. So Q3 equals to, what we will find, 3N by 4. Q3 equals to L plus, L is 80, plus 3N by 4 answer, minus CF, opposite upper value. By small f, 32, into h, 10. So Q3 equals to 90 minus 79 divided by 32 into 10 plus 80 at the end. So we got Q3 as 83.437. Once we got Q3 value, we have Q1, L plus N by 4 minus CF by small f into h. So n by 4 we will calculate now. N by 4, 120 by 4, 30. Once we got n by 4, that n by 4 we will check here. It lies in 36. So this is L, this is F, this is CF for Q1. So what we have? L plus 60 plus n by 4, which is 30, minus CF, opposite upper value, by small f, 21, into h. H is 10. Again, same thing. Don't take 60 first on the calculator. 30 minus 15 into 10 divided by 21 plus 60. So if you do that, you will get 60 minus 36. 30 minus 15 by 21 into 67.142. This is Q1. Check how many things we got. We got Q3. Then we got Q1. Then median we need to find. This afterwards we have to find this at the end. Median now. Median equals to L plus N by 2 minus CF by small f into H. So we will find N by 2 here beside this. 120 by 2, this is 60. Where we find 60? 60 lies here. This is median line. So L, F, opposite upper value CF. Don't confuse because 3 times L is there. We have to take median L. Median L is 70. N by 2 is 60. Minus CF, opposite upper value. By small f, 43. Into H, 10. 60 minus 36 into 10 divided by 43 plus 70. So which is 75.581. So median. Median is also known as Q2. We have Q3, Q1 and median. So we can have Pauli skewness now. Pauli's coefficient of skewness or as skewness based on quartiles. SKB we will write Q3 plus Q1 minus 2 median divided by Q3 minus Q1. So Q3 value 83.437 plus Q1 67.142 minus 2 into median divided by Q3 minus Q1. Adding, then add and subtract. So after adding, we find this is 150.579 minus 151.162 divided by subtraction 16.295. If we might subtract and divide, skewness will be minus 0.0357. This is skewness of Pauli. So skewness topic is completed. In skewness we have three types of questions. One is Karl-Pearson's coefficient of skewness when mode is defined. Second one is Karl-Pearson's coefficient of skewness when mode is ill-defined. And the third one is Pauli's coefficient of skewness. So these skewness unit is combination of previous topics itself. Here what we find in Pauli's, we have CI, FCF, where we will use this one to find median and quartiles earlier. What we need? Quartile 3, quartile 1. Second topic of central tendencies unit. Then we have median. Once you know how to find quartiles and median, what is Pauli's? Combination of those formulas. Q3 plus Q1 minus 2 median by Q3 minus Q1. Just writing the values of the particular terms, then you can get the answer by calculating. You have a provision of using calculator. You can use calculators in exam, so it's very easy to simplify this. So in measures of dispersion notes, I have included this skewness notes also at the end of that one. So this one, till here, topics are completed, only two units are completed. We can say three units if you find in textbook. Six topics are there. Out of six, one is theory topic, unit one. Rest of the three topics we have completed. So total four topics we have completed. One is only three topics we have completed, sorry. One, central tendency, second, dispersion, third, skewness. Now, fourth topic will be discussed in the next video. Correlation will be discussed in that.